Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm sharing with you guys a beginner's guide to healthy eating. So these are some guidelines that you can follow if you are new to healthy eating and you just kind of want to get started but you're not quite sure where. I also made you guys a free printable PDF, so if you'd like to pick that up, definitely grab that in the description box, and it kind of outlines all of these in one convenient place that you guys can download, refer back to, keep it on your phone, and all of that. So definitely download that, and let's get into it. So the first thing to do is to focus on real food, real whole food ingredients. These are typically things that you find in the perimeter of your grocery store. You know, they're one ingredient, they come as their whole form. They're things like broccoli and sweet potato and things like that. When transitioning to eating healthy, just switching to things that are made with whole foods is one of the biggest things that you can do for your health, because we want to be eating things that are, you know, mainly in their whole food form. That's where we want the majority of our diet and the foods that we eat to come from, is from real whole foods. So focusing on that instead of everything else is really going to help you when you're starting out that healthy eating. The next one is to cook your own meals. And that's because when we cook at home, we're a lot more in control of the things that go into our food. And we can use those whole foods that we, you know, we picked up and really just create delicious meals at home that are made with all of those great ingredients, because we know what's going into our food. We know there's nothing processed, artificial, and we know it's only good ingredients. So when we're starting out to eat healthy, it's really important to learn to cook at home and make your own meals. It's also a lot less expensive because a lot of the time we're paying for convenience when we go out. So this is a great way to not only eat healthy, but also stick into a budget. The next one is to consume healthy fats. If you've been subscribed to my channel for a while, you know I am a huge fan of healthy fats. And healthy fats are super important for our body. Not only are they the building blocks for a lot of hormones in our body, they give us great skin, great digestion, and great fuel for our brain as well. And so without all of these great healthy fats, our body is not able to function optimally. So these are things like avocado, nuts and seeds, coconut oil, olive oil. All of these great things are going to be so good and nourishing for your body. They're also going to help keep you full. So what healthy fats do is they are really satiating and they help to balance blood sugar. And when our blood sugar is out of balance, you know, that's when we get hangry, we get cravings and all that kind of stuff. So healthy fats are super important to incorporate at every meal, and you can definitely do so easily by, you know, adding nut butter to smoothies, avocado to salads, you know, everything like that. Definitely don't skip dressing on the salad. I know that was a trend a while back. You know, people would be like, no dressing, but that wonderful olive oil, that good quality olive oil on your salad is gonna do so much for your body, like inside and out. The next one is to minimize sugar. I find with a lot of packaged things or things we might be buying, we're unaware of just how much sugar we're consuming. A great example of this is when buying yogurt. A lot of the flavored yogurts, even vanilla flavor, have up to 15 grams of sugar per serving, which is 3 full teaspoons, which is quite a lot of sugar. So I find that by, you know, minimizing sugar and getting control of how much sugar you add to your foods can go a long way. So buying a, you know, a natural plain yogurt that doesn't have any added sugar, you can add your own sweetness by adding fresh berries or if you need a little bit of honey, but at least that way you're controlling it yourself at home versus, you know, having all these added sugar to things. A lot of the time also, sugar is added to a lot of processed foods to make it more palatable and to make you want to eat more of it. So it's important to be aware of these sugars. The next guideline is to focus on quality over calories. I have this happen a lot on my channel. People ask for the calorie content of my recipes. And what I really encourage on my channel is to focus on the quality of the ingredients that you are eating rather than the calories. An example I've given before is you know, the 100 calorie Oreo Fensations versus 200 calories of raw organic almonds. The almonds, A, react differently in your body because of their composition, but B, they're filled with so much more better quality things than the 100 calories of, you know, Oreo Fensations that are less calories, but are filled with processed chemicals and like garbage and crap. So focusing on the quality of what you're eating is a lot more important than focusing on calories, because they just don't react the same in the body. So it's really important, and that's definitely something I preach on my channel and why, you know, I never include calorie content on my recipes. It's because I want people to focus on the quality of what they are eating, because that is so much more important than the number of calories. The next one is to read your labels. And this also ties in to the sugar one that I mentioned, but it's so important to read labels to be aware of, you know, what is in our food and what are we consuming when we buy packaged goods. A lot of the time, you know, ingredients can be like a bunch of different things, or you may not even know what's in your food. So paying attention to when you're buying it, okay, what am I actually buying? Can I buy this, you know, ingredient off the shelf? If I can't buy it off the shelf, should I really be eating it? And that's, you know, something you want to address. If you can't pronounce it, if you don't know what that ingredient is and you can't, you know, buy it off the shelf, like you can't buy almonds off the shelf, like you can buy that off the shelf, but you can't buy, you know, monosodium glutamate, you know, off the shelf. So that's something that you kind of want to be aware of, is to really just focus on reading your labels and, hey, you know, what is in my food? And then that way you can make a better choice at the grocery store when comparing labels of different things you might be buying. The next guideline is to not forget about flavor. I find that a lot of people think that eating healthy has to be bland or that it's not delicious. But if you've made my recipes on my channel, you know that healthy is definitely delicious. So you really don't want to forget about flavor. I definitely don't eat, you know, boiled chicken and steamed broccoli. You want to have fun with it. You want to add different herbs and different spices and, you know, tahini and all these wonderful natural things that make food taste delicious. So don't forget about flavor. Don't be afraid of flavor and spices, because that's what's going to make your food taste delicious. It doesn't have to be boring and it doesn't have to be bland. If you need healthy recipes, definitely head over to my channel and head over to my healthy recipes playlist. All of them have so much flavor and they're really easy to make. So if you need ideas, that's definitely for you. But yeah, do not forget about flavor, because eating healthy does not have to be boring and it definitely can be super delicious. The next one is to have a couple staple recipes. These are really, you know, go-tos for you that you really enjoy, that are healthy, that you know that you can make. You know, if you're on a crunch or you don't know what to make, you have those staples to get you through. You know, some of mine are chia pudding, paleo porridge, you know, roasted sweet potato with tahini. There's so many different things. Find a healthy recipe that you really love. It can even be, you know, zoodles and tomato sauce, you know. Something simple that you enjoy, that you can make on a whim, that you can make when you don't know what else to make, and those will really help carry you through. So you're not feeling like you always have to find a new recipe to make or a new experiment. You have your tried and trues that you make, you know, all the time. The next guideline is that when you're hungry, eat. And I know this sounds, you know, a little bit, you know, simple, but I feel like a lot of the time people think that healthy doesn't mean satisfied or healthy means you're going to be hungry. And that's definitely not true. If you are actually experiencing physical hunger, then that's a cue of your sign of your body want to eat. So definitely, you know, when you're hungry, eat. Choose a balanced snack, something that's made of, you know, fats and protein and is going to be really nourishing to your body. Or, you know, if you're getting into intermittent fasting, you know, and you get hungry, eat. Don't prolong, you know, your eating because you're trying to do intermittent fasting. Slowly work up to, you know, intermittent fasting and how many hours you're fasting. But definitely, if you are hungry, then you need to eat. And my next guideline is to find healthy alternatives for what you like. So there's definitely a healthy alternative nowadays to just about anything. You know, if you've seen my desserts, we make cookies, we make brownies, we've made even like Trix and Reese's Cup cereal. So there really is a healthy alternative for everything. Whether you make it at home or a lot of companies now are coming out with some great healthy alternatives. One of my great like healthy alternatives that I like is Smart Sweets. They're like a gummy candy, but there's only 3 grams of sugar per bag. They're made with a lot better ingredients. There's no artificial colors or anything like that in their stuff. So there's definitely nowadays a healthy alternative to anything. You know, there's healthier alternatives to chips and Doritos and, you know, cookies. There's so many things. So I really encourage you to like find healthier alternatives for what you like. You know, you can still eat chocolate, but eat chocolate that's made with better ingredients at a higher cacao percentage or are sugar free. And there's like tons of online places too that you can get these things more affordable. If you're in the States, there's Thrive Market. If you're from Canada, like I am, Natura Market has some really great healthy options, all in terms of like chips, crackers, candy, and all that, that are just made with better ingredients, and you can still satisfy that need for like when you want a cookie, when you want a brownie, or when you want candy, but you're gonna do your body a favor by not putting that toxic, harmful stuff into your body. So I hope these guidelines were helpful for you guys. Don't forget to download the free PDF so that you have this all in one place. I will also leave a healthy recipe on the screen here to give you guys some really great inspiration. And yeah, I hope you guys are all having a fabulous day, and I will see you in my next video. Bye guys.